Welcome to Mongoose channel. Have you ever had to build a web UI dashboard on a Teensy 4.1 with a remote firmware update support? Let me show you a fast and easy way to do it. Go to mongoose.ws, click on the Mongoose Wizard button. This is a default dashboard which we can customize. We can add or remove pages, and we can change the content of any page. Let's use this default dashboard. Click on the Code tab, then choose the target board, Teensy 4.1. Download the generated project. Open it in Arduino and flash it. Open the serial console. Reboot the board to get its IP address from the logs. Load the IP address into your browser, and here is the web dashboard. Now we can link web UI controls to the hardware. Let's look at the LED toggles. Each toggle references a RESTful API, LEDs LED1, LED2, and LED3. If we open an API editor, we can see that the respective LED's API endpoint has three Boolean attributes. Open the generated mongooseglue.h and see that the LED's API gets translated into the C structure called LEDs, with three Boolean values and two functions, a getter function and a setter function. Let's open mongooseglue.c and scroll to the implementation. As we can see, the default implementation is just a hardware agnostic stub that uses a global variable that holds LED values. The web UI uses these two functions to display LED values and to modify them. In order to attach the web UI to the real hardware, we need to edit these two functions. And instead of using a stub variable, use the real hardware. Let's do that. Include arduino.h to get access to the Arduino API. Edit the glue LED's get function to read an LED. We have only one LED, so ignore LED2 and LED3. Edit the glue LED's set function to write an LED. Now it's time to use the remote firmware update feature to update the board with this new functionality. Choose Sketch Export Compiled Binary. This generates an ELF file in the build directory. For the firmware update, we need a bin file, so let's convert the ELF file into a bin file. Go to the firmware update page, click on Select Bin File, and choose the firmware bin file we just created. Wait for the update to complete. Now we can toggle the LED from the dashboard. The next question is, how about MQTT and TLS? The answer to that is in the next videos. As always, thanks for watching.